What's happening, guys? Keith here with another Impact Wrestling review. So tonight we're going to take a look at the November 1st edition of Impact, what I thought was a really good episode. All the matches pretty much made sense. There was a reason for them to be happening, for the most part. We did have one that, which we'll get into when we get to there. But they really built toward Final Hour, which takes place next week. That should finish off the New York set of tapings. And then we move to Las Vegas next weekend for tapings Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, which I would assume probably takes us to the end of the year, which will probably lead to Homecoming. But yeah, great show. Start off with Willie Mack versus Rich Swann. I think at least three out of the five matches that happened over the course of the evening could have main evented the show. Like I said, Rich Swann and Willie Mack open the show here. This was Willie Mack's singles debut. They gave this match a little less than 10 minutes, but they definitely made great use of the time. One of the chops that Willie Mack hit Rich Swann with sounded absolutely brutal, and you could just see the look on Rich's face, like, yeah, that hurt. We did see Willie hit a coast-to-coast dropkick while Rich Swann was in the Tree of Woe position in one corner. He went up to the other corner, dropkick. Beautiful spot, but Swann actually eventually goes over with a Phoenix Splash. A little surprising that Willie suffered a loss in his singles debut match, but Swann could use the win there. He has lost a handful of big singles matches recently against Brian Cage, but speaking of Cage, I really want to see him and Willie Mack square off here in Impact. Just both big men with high-flying ability. I think it's going to be a big match down the road, possibly for the X Division Championship. But we will see, because that is tied up between Callahan and Brian Cage. But yeah, this was a great way to open the show. Like I said, this match could have main evented the show. I think they made reference to that, saying, you know, we opened the show tonight with a main event quality match. But good stuff there. Then we go, I guess, backstage. I don't know where Sammy was, but I guess technically they were in Ohio, because that's where they invited Brian Cage to. He said that he beat Brian Cage. Now he's coming for his X Division Championship. Sammy invites Cage to Rockstar Pro to face him, which we will see later on in the evening. Then we get the Desi Hit Squad, the newly formed, reformed Desi Hit Squad, with Rohit Raju and Raj Singh, who is the son of Gursinder Gama Singh. And they face the Beach Bums, which I'm guessing is local talent from maybe Creative Pro or someone like that in the area. I did see when I was there for Bound for Glory, we saw the Creative Pro truck outside of the arena, which I'm guessing that's the ring Impact used this week. This match, it kind of just happened. Again, just not sure where they're going with the whole Desi Hit Squad thing. Gursinder getting kicked out. Is he going to come back? Are we going to see some tension between the former member and the new team? But yeah, this was a pretty quick match. Ended with Rohit hitting a jumping knee and Raj hit a Samoan drop. Kind of uneventful. And like I said, it just kind of turns off the crowd. They are getting go-away heat. Not heel heat, go-away heat from the crowd. But again, I'm going to give Impact the benefit of the doubt here, see what their long-term plan is with the Desi Hit Squad. I just hope they don't keep spinning their wheels, and that's why we got a character change or things like that. So, yeah, this continues. They seem to be a staple here, so it is what it is. And we see the OGs on the streets of New York. King talks about Phoenix being one of Conan's boys, so that is why we saw the OGs target him last week. Homicide, he says he's going to finish off the bootleg Skeletor tonight. And that is our main event for the evening, Homicide versus Pentagon Jr. Then we see LAX hanging out at the bar in the Melrose Ballroom. Conan runs down Seidel and Page. Conan says he isn't worried about the OGs going after the Lucha Brothers because he knows they can handle them. So that's a little interesting there. I wonder how this is going to eventually turn out. Are we going to end up getting the Lucha Brothers versus LAX? I'll talk about it a little more after the main event, but I think that's definitely where they should go. Then we get a video package of Eddie and Moose hyping their match next week at Final Hour. Heard great things about this match. Very much looking forward to it. Probably the match we were supposed to get at Bound for Glory. And then we head to Rockstar Pro, where Sammy Callahan and the Chris Brothers there, and they beat up a Brian Cage impersonator, which I believe it was Clayton Gaines who was portraying Brian Cage, but yeah, they ran through this whole thing, which wasn't a huge shocker, but next week we will actually get that match, which is announced later on in the evening. Then we see Eli Drake backstage, and he walks into a broom closet, which we see Joseph Parks sitting there, and he is eating, I guess, leftover Chinese food. I think that's what he said. Eli tells him he is suing Impact. Park gets excited about this. He says, do you want to make it a class action lawsuit? We can get the whole roster involved. Eli says, let's punch that ticket, and leaves and says, dummy. And then all of a sudden you hear Joseph Park going, yeah, yeah. So this is kind of the direction I expected them to go in. Got that comedic aspect of it. Probably eventually turn into Eli and Joseph Park, Abyss, in a one-off match. But let's roll with it and see how it goes. This was actually probably one of my favorite segments with the Desi Hit Squad. They're obviously backstage celebrating their victory. We get Scarlett interrupting them. Gama Singh tells the two guys, Raj and Rohit, not to get distracted by girls. So Gama walks up to Scarlett and starts wooing her. Rohit then interrupts and tells Scarlett, she's like, he's a 65-year-old man. That's his son, and he is happily married. Gama's like, what the hell? So he starts yelling at him, calling him a liar. And then she tells Gama about her talent search and tells him to send a video to her. So that was pretty funny. Then we had Taya versus Tessa, which was a Bound for Glory rematch. I was kind of surprised this wasn't going to take place on the final hour. However, due to the finish of the match, I get why they put it here. Tessa hit an absolutely nasty suicide dive onto Taya on the outside. She pushed the guardrail back definitely a couple feet. It seemed like they moved the front row back a little bit, because otherwise that would have been disastrous had that gone into where the front row was originally, probably for Bound for Glory. Taya was in control, hits a crossbody on the outside. Both women get back in the ring. Tessa pushes the ref toward Taya. He turns around, and then Tessa just lays out the ref. So Taya wins by DQ. Obviously, this feud is not over, but they put on a good match from what we got of it. I mean, it's great to see Taya back. Definitely seems like she deserves to be in this position of going up against Tessa. So this is the number one knockouts feud. Not a surprise here. The only other thing really going on is the whole Ali, Soo Young, Kiera, Rosemary thing, which we actually saw a little bit of later on in the evening. Now we have Johnny Impact and Killer Cross promoting their match for next week on Final Hour. This was really good. Johnny really did a good job of building up Killer Cross as a psychopath, but very, very interesting to see how they book this match. I mean, Johnny is still very new in his title reign. I mean, he only won it a few weeks back at Bound for Glory. They did make mention that Killer Cross is undefeated in Impact, so this is really Killer Cross's first big match. So very interested to see how they book this and if this is going to be a long-term thing, which I would assume we won't get a actual real finish next week, but we'll see how it goes. Then we get a promo video for Jordan Grace. She hypes up the knockout division, but says that none of them brings what Jordan Grace brings, and she debuts next week on Final Hour. Glad they're really building her up. She is a tremendous athlete at 22 years old, very young. I mean, Tessa's only 23, so their knockouts division has great, great young talent. Then we get the GWN flashback. Then we have a little promo from Phoenix, and then he tells the OGs that they attacked him from behind last week, that they forgot about his brother, which leads to Pentagon coming in, and he's hyping up his match with Homicide later on in the evening. I really like that they let Pentagon speak Spanish and just have the words on the screen. They're not forcing the issue like other companies do. So I like that about Impact. Then we have Brian Cage answering, I guess, Sami Callihan's actual challenge. Cage says he will show up at Rockstar Pro next week with the X Division Championship, and he will challenge Sami Callihan. Then Josh and Don kind of hype up Final Hour for next week, which we get the debut of Jordan Grace. Moose versus Eddie Edwards, Callihan versus Brian Cage for the X Division Championship at Rockstar Pro. So we haven't seen one of those matches in a while where we go to another company for the match. So see how they handle this one. At least it's running with storyline. It's not like a random match that we see. And then we have the Impact World Championship with Killer Cross and Johnny Impact. We do get one more match made for the show later on in the evening. And also we get some more of Eli Drake and Joseph Park. And then up next we have LAX versus Matt Sydal and Ethan Page. And this match happened because of the interaction between the two last week after LAX beat the Heavenly Bodies. But this was a good back and forth match. I really, really like the teaming of Matt Sydal and Ethan Page, at least giving Sydal something to do now that he's in a tag team rather than being a single star. Definitely hard for anyone on the roster to match the presence of LAX. Just they get a great reaction regardless of where they are. I really hope that Impact is able to lock them up long term. They did just become the longest reigning tag team champions, passing Beer Money's 514 combined days as champions. So huge stat there. Yeah, good match. LAX went over with a double team combination of a suplex into an Ushiguroshi neckbreaker. So they busted out that. Like I said, LAX usually has a new maneuver in their arsenal every match. I did really enjoy the part in the match where Matt Sydal did his thing where he goes underneath the ring, but forgetting that there's an extra man there, Konnan kind of followed him around and saw where he came out from underneath the apron, and him and Sydal, they just had a good back and forth. I like that. I thought this match was put together pretty well, and yeah, pretty solid. So we go backstage, and Allie is apologizing to Kiera for leaving her last week in her match with Soo Young. Kiera obviously just wants to make sure that Allie is okay. Allie keeps saying that she is fine, everything's okay. Then Kiera starts yelling at her, telling her she's lying, and Allie finally gives in and says she hasn't been the same since she went into the undead realm. Kiera says it started with Sue and it will end with Sue. You could tell that this was filmed backstage during the beginning of the Knockouts Championship match because you could hear the announcer announcing everything. So, yeah, just a little something. Then we got our main event of the evening, Homicide versus Pentagon Jr., first time ever match. They did make that announcement. Hard-hitting back-and-forth match. It was surprisingly kept pretty clean with no outside interference, even though we had Hernandez and King on the outside along with Phoenix. There were a few clunky spots, but they seemed to work past it and work through it, like one spot in the corner where Pentagon turned it into a backstabber, but it didn't look too pretty, but like I said, they worked through it. Finish saw Homicide go for the Gringo Killer. Pentagon was able to get out of it and rolls up Homicide for the victory. After the match, Hernandez rushes the ring, attacks Pentagon. Phoenix starts to get involved, but then King rushes the ring with the slapjack in hand. Take out Pentagon, take out Phoenix, and we have a tag team match set up for next week. So it'll be interesting to see how this one plays out as well. Does the Lucha Brothers go over and then say, you know what, we beat them, we deserve a tag team championship shot? Or does the OGs go over and say, well, we can't do anything with LAX, so you guys are going to get the tag team title shot anyway? Be interesting to see how they book it, but I really hope this goes into an LAX versus Lucha Brothers feud regardless, because that's a match that I think a lot of people would definitely watch. Hopefully one they would save for a big show. I don't think that's a match meant for TV. Definitely a pay-per-view quality match there. But yeah, no, Final Hour looks really good next week. And then we ended the show by Cross cutting a promo, obviously hyping his match with Johnny Impact. Definitely could be easily the biggest heel on the show. They're just doing such a good job with Killer Cross and his whole psychopathic thought process and things like that. Just a lot of good stuff with him. With the absence of Aries, they need to put someone in that top heel position. I think Killer Cross is going to work out pretty well. I guess you could just switch back and forth between him and Moose, because Moose seems to be getting over pretty good as a heel as well. But the viewership, unfortunately, wasn't that great for this episode. A little better than last week. It was up 7%. I think last week's had 98,000 viewers. This week did 105. They ranked 147 out of 150, so still not great, but again, such a tough time slot. I had to watch the show three different segments. I watched a little when I got home from work yesterday, some more last night, and then I finally finished the show up this morning. It's tough for me to catch it, so unfortunately, that's why I have to record Saturday. Surprisingly, this was Pop's second highest rated show of the evening for Thursday night. Apparently, The Young and the Restless did 310,000 at the 7 p.m. time slot, which that's a little crazy. But the YouTube numbers seem to drop off a little bit. This week's show only had like a combined 290,000 views on all the highlights and clips from the show. Last week's had 430,000, so again, a pretty big drop off. And the highest viewed segment of the week was Tessa vs. Taya. That had 35,000 views. And last week's highest viewed segment was 55,000 views, which had Soo Young and Allie in their stare-off. It was surprising that Impact didn't put the Allie Kiera segment on their YouTube page, because usually Allie is in one of the highest rated segments. So I figured that would have been an easy thing for Impact to capitalize on. Impact did announce that they will be partnering with PPW, which is Pennsylvania Premier Wrestling, for a one-night-only show called New Beginnings. This will take place January 26th, 2019, in Hazleton, Pennsylvania. So that is set to take place then. Also, apparently it was mentioned. I didn't notice it because, again, I watched it in three different segments. I fast-forwarded through all the commercials. But there was an Arrow Lucha commercial that debuted during the show. Or aired during the show, said to be coming in 2019. So I don't know what this means for Impact. Are they going to take the spot of Impact on Pop? Impact going to a new network? Who knows? But very interesting there. That's pretty much all I have. Like I said, I really enjoyed this week's episode. I thought they did a good job. All the matches pretty much seemed to make sense. A reason for happening, and then final hour, it doesn't seem like anything's really thrown together. They have built towards some stuff. It'll be interesting to see what they build for the upcoming months, since we head to Las Vegas next weekend to start the tapings there, which I would assume, like I said, brings us through the end of the year. Next week, I'm going to try to get some more content up. I'm going to try something a little different. No Impact report this week. Again, I have more stuff going on this weekend. But yeah, I think I'm going to do some shorter videos throughout the week, a little bit of news things. I'm going to do a review of the press pass, just a small video, so you guys don't have to sit there for an hour and watch it. You can just check out my video to get the highlights from it. Hopefully, if news comes up, I'll let any of you guys know if stuff comes up during the week. And then, yeah, I'll have my Impact review next Saturday, hopefully. Sunday, maybe I'll try something with the Impact report. I don't know. I think next weekend's my first weekend free in over a month, so hopefully I'll get something up. So I'm done rambling on. Thanks for checking out my video, and until next time, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Thanks, guys. Bye.